Carla Stecco is an orthopedic surgeon and professor of anatomy at the University of Padova in Italy, and one of the world's leading scientists in this field. As well as her discovery of a new cell, she is also researching what causes pain to occur in parts of the body not impacted, for example, by a trauma.
This is the Galileo Galileo room. The student create a podium to stand up Galileo and to permit to all the people to see Galileo.
Padova is home to the world's oldest anatomical theater, previously used for dissecting bodies.
Now I see the history of Padova, but I see also the future of fascial anatomy and the fascial research, because in the past the human body was cut in many different pieces. And we learn about the liver, about the stomach, about the different muscles, the joint, and in such a way we lost the global view of the body. Fascia was really totally forgotten in the past. They were not able to see the innervation of a fascia. And consequently, they considered the fascia just as an anatomical structure without a true importance. Now we change the perspective because fortunately we have understood the role of fascia and that the different elements interfere one with the other, that all the elements are connected to each other.
Ma dai, fantastico!
So we decide how the hip can interfere with the back, with the knee, how an old trauma in the ankle can create back pain. If we understand that connection, we take care in a different way our patient. Maybe then we need also the neurosurgeon, the orthopedic surgeon, but before we have a global vision of the patient. And I think that can change really the medicine of the future. The good fascia is a fascia that is very well organized, so with all the collagen fiber, with a precise direction that permit to connect as a bridge the correct part of the body, and at the same time, gliding surface that permit to move respect to the surrounding tissue. When the fascia start to be altered, one of the first elements that we can see also with the ultrasound is a lack of gliding. It's like that the two fascial layers, or the fascia and the nerve, or the fascia and the muscle, are attached and don't move. So if we start with manual treatment to create a friction, after 1-2 minutes, we feel that this stuck tissue start to move, start to glide. We have a precise anatomy into the fascia that connect the body in a precise way. So we have some line along the body that permit to connect the feet with the knee, with the hip, with the back, until the neck. And all that element are organized in a very precise anatomical way.
Here we can see a small piece of a fascia, and particularly this is the galeacapitis. You can see also as inside there is a small vessel that we can see here, and also some muscular fiber like that or like that, that create a specific tension into the fascia. So we can imagine that if after, for example, whiplash, we create a contraction of this muscle creates like a tension inside the fascia, like that modify all the structure of the fascia. And it's for that the fascia is a bridge that connects all the different elements together. And without the bridge, and without considering the bridge, it's impossible to understand the human body.
Fascia that have become tangled or gone through a trauma will affect a person's movement. And because recent discoveries show that there are 6 times more nerve cells in the fascia than in muscles, fascia problems can be linked to pain in the lower back, shoulder, knee, anywhere the fascia exists.
In the past, I was convinced that the fascia is just a connective tissue with some collagen fiber, some fibroblasts, and it's all. Now we know that there are many different cells, and we need to study all the cells, how to transfer to the inflammation, to the hormones, to the aging, to the food, and all that aspect need a specific research. And only creating a group, an international group, that look about the different topic, we can really understand the fascia.
It has to be autonomic, yeah. And probably from the ganglia.
So they will go from the celiac.
In the past, I've thought as a fascia, as one fascia, that was almost the same everywhere. Now we know that we have the superficial fascia, the muscular fascia, the visceral fascia, and all that element have a precise anatomical aspects, different innervation, different fibrous component, different cells, and answer to different mechanical input. That element interact each other in a very precise way. So the organs through the fascia, through the visceral fascia, are connected with the locomotor system, with the muscle. And maybe a person that have a chronic abdominal pain start to have also back pain, or start to have pain in the neck. And only if we understand such interaction, we can really care the patient. Actually, the people are treated just with pills that reduce the symptoms, reduce the pain, but don't care really the fascia, don't restore the proper anatomy of a fascia. The best will be to understand all the elements that can affect the fascia and to prevent the alteration of a fascia. Because I really think that if we are able to understand all the elements, we can avoid the aging, we can avoid the degeneration of the joint, we can avoid many different pathologies in the organ, in the muscle, in the joints, and consequently it means that we can become older in a better way.